Hello everyone, welcome to our next video of General Mathematics of class 10, and today we are going to continue with exercise 1.1. We had done a few sums from this exercise in our previous video, that is in the part 1 of this exercise. So right now we skipped a few sums. Question number 2, 3, 4, 5, these are the 4 sums that we skipped. So today we are going to do some of these. I'm going to show you how to do these sums, how to solve them, and I'm going to give some tasks to you as well. So let us start with question number 2. And see how to do this. So it is a different type of sum, as I have said. In your previous classes, you have not solved sums like this. So it is more of a theoretical based sum. So let's see. We have to think about it in a different way. So what is given in question number 2? So in question number 2, if you read the question, show that any positive odd integer is of the form 6q plus 1. Or 6q plus 3 or 6q plus 5, where q is some integer. So looking into question number 2, how to solve this? So we'll write like this. We'll consider that a be any positive integer. Let a be any positive integer and b equal to 6. Okay, 6, why have you chosen 6? 6 because it is given in the question. If you look at the coefficient of q, it is always 6. 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3 and 6q plus 5. So in this case, therefore, we can write it in the form. Therefore, a can be written as 6q plus 1, r. So for any positive integer a, and if b is equal to 6, then a can be expressed in the form of 6q plus r, where q is any integer, means obviously a positive integer, and r is also the remainder. So now what will be the value of r? So here q is a positive integer, and what will be the value of r? The value of r will range from 1 to 3, 4 and 5. Okay, so why is the value of r ranging between 0 to 5? So the thing is, this is a is equal to 6q plus r is just the same formula that we used to solve previous sums, that is dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So if a is the dividend, then 6 is the divisor, q is the quotient and r is the remainder. So d is equal to d into q plus r. Okay, so that is the formula that we are using here. So what happens here, if you divide any number with any other number, then the remainder will always be less than the divisor. Suppose you have to divide 5 with 2 or 5 by 2, then 2 2s are 4 and the remainder is 1. Okay, now you have to divide, suppose 6 by 2, then 3 is a 6, remainder is 0. Now choose any number, suppose 15, you have to divide by 2, it is 2, 7 is a 14, remainder is 1. Choose any other number, suppose you use 105 or 106, you divide by 2, it is 5 is a 10, 6, we have 6, 3 is a, it is 0, 6, it is 0. So you can see the remainder is always 0 or 1. So if the remainder is either 0 or 1, that means it is always less than our divisor, right? 2 is the divisor. So the remainder is always less than the divisor. So here also, here our divisor is 6. Therefore, the remainder will always be less than the divisor. Since d is the divisor, the remainder will always stay less than the divisor. So it is between 0 and 5. Okay. So now how do we proceed with this sum? So we have written a is equal to 6q plus r. So how do we use this? Let me erase these parts first. I'm sorry. Okay, let's continue. So that means a will, therefore, the values, the possible values are of a are, if r is equal to 0, then a is equal to 6q, which is equal to 2 into 3q. That means 2 is a factor. So if 2 is a factor, it is even, right? Now if r is equal to 1, then a is equal to 6q. Then a is equal to 6q plus 1. So now 6q plus 1 means it is 2 into 3q, but we have 1 as an extra. So 2 into 3q is divisible by 2, but this 1 makes it an odd number. So therefore it is odd. Okay. So now let us move ahead. Let me erase this part. So if now the next part is, if r is equal to 2, then what happens? Then a is equal to 6q plus 2. So from here you can take 2 common and you get 3q plus 1. So since this whole part is divisible by 2, therefore it is even. Now if r is equal to 3, then a is equal to 6q plus 3. So it is 2 into 3q, but 3 cannot be taken as, you cannot take 2 common out of 3. So therefore it becomes odd. This part is even. Even number plus odd number is always odd. Last, or you have 2 left. If r is equal to 4, then what do we have? Then a is equal to 6q plus 4. So from here you can take again 2 common, it becomes 3q plus 2. As it is divisible by 2, therefore it is even. Similarly, in the last one, if r is equal to 5, then a is equal to 6q plus 5, which is 2 into 3q plus 5, which is odd. Okay, so if you look into all the numbers that we use, the different values of r that we used, r equal to, starting from r equal to 0, then r equal to 1, r equal to 2, 3, 4 and 5. So when r was 0, a was even. When r was 1, a was odd. Here r is 2. What is the value of a? It is even. When r is 3, then it is odd. When r is 4, it is even. When r is 5, it is again odd. So if we have to sum it up, so we can see that therefore a is odd when r is equal to 3, 3 and 5. That means, or that is, any positive odd number can be expressed in the form of 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3 or 6q plus 5. Hope you have understood what I have tried to explain here. So let me talk you through the whole sum again. So what we did first, we took a number a and we took another number b, which is equal to 6. And why did we choose 6? Because in the question it was given the 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3 and 6q plus 5. So in this case, we can, using the formula dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder, what we can write that for any positive integer a can be expressed in the form of 6q plus r, where r is the remainder and q is our Quotient. So the values of r can be either 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. These are the possible values of remainder. So using this, we can write that a can six values. Either it can be 6q, or it can be 6q plus 1, 6q plus 2, 6q plus 3, 6q plus 4, or 6q plus 5. Right? Now, when it is 6q, obviously it is divisible by 2, therefore it is an even number. When it is 6q plus 1, it becomes 6q is divisible by 2, but 1 is divisible by 2, but 1 is an odd number. When we add it to 2, 6q plus 2, that means 6q is also even, 2 is also even, so the whole number becomes even. When you add 3, then 6q is even, but 3 is odd, therefore this combination becomes odd. With 4 again it becomes even, and with 5 again it becomes odd. So what we need to show that any positive number can be expressed in the form of 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3, or 6q plus 5. So we have seen that when r is 1, 3, or 5, then only the value of a is odd. Okay, so then the 6 we have proven, the 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3, or 6q plus 5 are the different ways by which you can express any positive odd number. Okay, I hope this is clear. Let us try one more sum, and this time we are going to do number 5. Question number 5, but this time I am not going to do the writing. The writing will be same as we have done in question number 3. Question number 2. I am going to explain how to do question number 5. So in 5 they have asked, use Euclid's division lemma to show that the cube of any positive integer is of the form 9m, 9m plus 1, or 9m plus 8. So here the number is 9. Okay. So how can we do this? So let us, here we will take, what we will do, that for any, let a equal to 9, a be any positive integer, let a be any positive integer and b equal to 9. So therefore a can be written as 9q plus r, same ways in the, just like in question number 2, we can here instead of 6 we will write 9. So it can be written as a is equal to 9q plus r, and what can be the value of r? R can be, r will always be less than, r will always be less than 9. Okay, so the values of r will be either 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, so on up to 8. Okay, the value of r can be between 0 and 8. Okay, so now what we can do, we can write a in different ways. So when r is equal to 0, when r equal to 0, then a is equal to only 9q. So we have to show that the cube of any positive integer is of the form 9m, 9m plus 1, or 9m plus 8. So this time we have to find the cube, that means we have to find a cube. So a cube is equal to 9q whole cube. So it is, we can write it like 9 cube is 9 9 is 81, 81 into 9 is 729. Q cube. Now this can be expressed as 9, if we take 9 common, then we can write 81 Q cube. So here this 81 Q cube is any number, let us consider 89 Q cube as M. Okay, so here we can write it as 9M. So if you look into our question, we needed to show that one of these is 9M. So here the cube of A is of the form 9M. Okay, now let us, so when suppose r is equal to 1, then what will happen? Then a becomes 9q plus 1 whole cube. So it is a cube, that is 9q cube, plus thrice a square b, a square b, plus thrice a b cube plus b cube. This is a plus b whole cube formula. So it is 729 q cube plus 9 square is 81, 81 into 3 is 243 q plus 27 q plus 1. So from, if you look into the first three terms, here 9 is common. So if we take 9 common, we can write 81 q cube plus 27q plus 3q, but this one will remain outside. So here this part is can be any value, and this value can be taken as any variable. Suppose instead of writing this whole expression, we can write it as 9m and plus 1. So again here, if you look into this form, this is the form we wanted in the question. Means any the cube of any positive integer. I'm sorry, here it will be a cube. So a cube, so the cube of any positive integer is of the form 9m plus 1 now. Okay, when we did r equal to 0, we got 9m. Now that we have done r equal to 1, we got again 9m plus 1. If you try and do r equal to 3, you will get 9m plus 8 and so on. Okay, so this is one way of solving this sum. Okay, you can try r equal to 2 also, r equal to 3 also, but this will become very lengthy because there are 9 possible values. R can have 9 possible values. So how to make it simple? Okay, how to make it simple? So let's try. This time, instead of taking b equal to 9, we will take let a equal to a be any positive integer. I'm sorry. Let a be any positive integer. And b equal to 3. So we will take the factor of 9. So factor of 9 is 3. So b equal to 3. So therefore a will be equal to 3q plus 1. I mean r. And r can have values less than 3. So it will be either 0, 1 or 2. So therefore now what you can do, you can find a cube is equal to 3. I mean sorry, we missed one step. So now when a is equal to, I mean when r equal to 0, then a equal to 3q. So therefore a cube is equal to 3q whole cube, which is 27q cube. From here you can take 9 common, you will get 3q cube, which can be written as 9m. You consider this 3q as any integer or any value of m, so you can write it as 9m. Now if you, instead of taking r equal to 0, if when we take when r equal to 1, then a is equal to 3q plus 1. Now if you find the cube of a, you will get 3q plus 1 whole cube, right? Now you write the formula, it will be 27q cube plus thrice a square, which means 3 into the square is 9, 9 to the 20, yeah, so it will be 27q square plus 9q plus 1. From here also you can take 9 common, you will get 3q cube plus 3q square plus q and plus 1. Now here also this part, you can consider this as any value of m, it can be 9m plus 1. And next one, what you will do is instead of taking r equal to 1, you will take r equal to 2. When you try that out by yourself, you will try it out by yourself. When r equal to 2, a is equal to 3q plus 2. So therefore, r cube will be 3q cube plus 3 into 3q square. I mean, sorry. It will be 3 into 3q whole square plus 2 plus 3 into 3q into 2 square plus 2 cube. So ultimately you will get 9 common, you will get one part here, plus 2 cube is 8. Okay, so which can be written as 9 into m plus 8. If you consider this part, whatever value you get here, if you consider this as m, then you can write 9m plus 8. So for these three values of r, you will get either 9m or 9m plus 1 or 9m plus 8. And that is how you solve question number 5. Question number 3 will be your homework and question number 4 as well. So if you have understood question number 2, you can do question number 4 easily. And this is how you do question number 5. So I hope you have understood the different sums that you did today. If you have any confusion, make sure you ask me in the comment section or you can contact me directly. So thank you everyone for watching today's video. And until next time, cheers.